Last year, Apple launched the iPhone X, which marked over a decade of smartphone production by the company. This new model brought certain new features like the bezel-less screen and wireless charging, but none of those features are as huge as the one packed into that tiny notch in the front of the phone. With Face ID, Apple were the first to introduce computer vision to millions of people around the world. Now, I don't expect most people to know the actual term for it, or even understand the specifics of how it works, but computer vision is poised to completely change how we interact with machines in the future. Now, before we continue, I'd like you all to know I make new videos every week on Sundays. So please leave a like if you enjoy the video and subscribe to the channel for more great content. Computer vision is a field of artificial intelligence which aims to give computers a visual understanding of the world around them by image processing techniques and machine learning. This is not to be confused with machine vision, however, which is used in industries to automatically analyze and inspect predictable or known events. The field of computer vision emerged in the 1950s when Frank Rosenblatt invented the perceptron. The machine used a very early artificial neural network and was able to sort images into very simple categories like triangles and squares. The goal of computer vision has always been to emulate human vision using digital images through three main processing components, which are image acquisition, image processing, and finally, image analysis and understanding. To properly explain how all these processes combine to make a computer vision system, I'll use the iPhone X's Face ID. Face ID uses a combination of light projectors and sensors to take several images of your facial features in order to form a 3D map. This serves as a combined image acquisition and processing phase, which ends up sending a 3D mathematical template of your face to the neural engine within the smartphone. The final process occurs when the user tries to unlock the phone again. The aforementioned 3D template is then used to compare with the image acquired in real time, and once authenticated, the device is unlocked. To be honest, Apple's application of computer vision is only at the tip of the iceberg when we consider just how much we can achieve with this technology once it has fully matured. Google debuted the visual search tool known as Google Lens late last year, and today, owners of Pixel phones can get details on just about anything they see by pointing their cameras at it. Self-driving cars are all the rage today in the tech sector, as companies like Waymo, Uber, and GM fight to be the first to give customers access to true autonomous vehicles. What do you get when you add robots which can carry out repetitive actions plus computer vision? You get service bots, and they are coming for low-skilled jobs. And when I say low-skilled jobs, I mean everything from food production to secretarial jobs. These robots will be capable of carrying out tasks without the assistance of a human being. Fashion is yet another sector which could benefit greatly from computer vision. In 2016, couture designer Jason Gretsch worked with IBM Watson to design a 12-piece collection called Cognitive Couture. The collection was made by analyzing 10 years of runway fashion and social media to help the designer explore favorite trends, colors, and textures. Of course, a technology this powerful was inevitably going to find its way into government surveillance platforms. Europe, America, and China have all begun applying computer vision to hunt criminals or those intending to commit a crime. As if that wasn't bad enough, Google, the same guys who professed the "don't be evil" mantra not too long ago, are openly aiding the United States drone program. Known internally as Project Maven, the project aims to speed up analysis of drone footage by automatically classifying images of objects and people. Other possible uses of computer vision can be found in the fields of sports refereeing and medical diagnosis. This is, of course, not a comprehensive list, however, considering there are tons of applications which will spring up in the coming years. For those terrified at the prospects of drones hunting them down autonomously in the not-too-distant future, I have some good news. Current machine learning techniques utilized for computer vision require significant computational power and data. Processing the data in particular is a big problem. There are even reports that big companies like Tesla, Waymo, and Uber employ thousands of people, often in offshore outsourcing centers in India or China. The primary jobs of these workers is to teach the self-driving cars to recognize pedestrians, cyclists, and other obstacles. The workers do this by manually marking up or labeling thousands of hours of video footage, often frame by frame, taken from prototype vehicles which operate around test beds, such as Silicon Valley. The primary reason why this manual approach is utilized is because self-driving vehicles simply lack the computational power to track stationary and moving objects simultaneously in real time. In a nutshell, it might take at least another decade or even two to bring reliable and precise computer vision to the mass market. But make no mistake, it will come eventually. And when it does, it will change our perception of the world almost completely.